Hello and welcome back to yet another episode of Divinity Original Sins 2, the definitive edition. My name is Syken and we're going to play Honor Mode Plus, the more difficult version than just normal Honor Mode. We're playing on the highest difficulty level, but we're upping it one notch by making the enemies not only our level, but two levels above our level. I am currently considering the last skill, just got it. And I am concerned after our last fight because we're going to go up against Trumpdor and it's probably not going to be an easy fight. So the whole idea behind the whole Trumpdor fight that's going to be ahead of us is let's make sure that we're going to survive and take as little damage as possible. Plus, there will be one real version of Trumpdor spawning over here. And that single version needs to be found by us immediately and essentially killed as soon as possible. So we're going to trigger. The actual fight. This is the real Trumpdor. Which just got us in fight. We're going to use every trick in the book to maybe not get into combat. Yeah, it's probably not going to work out. Okay. So, this is the real Trumpdor here. By so this one step at a time. We don't want to be stunned. So we gotta get some magical armor. Alright, fair enough. Secondly, we want to segregate Trumpdor from the others, which means we're moving over here. We're going to get enough time. Oh, he has fortified himself. Well, our plan just went out of the window. I wanted to basically teleport him in, but that's not going to work if he's going to be fortified. Which means we got to get out of here as fast as possible. Unfortunately, can't jump anywhere, and we have limited means of teleporting. But I also don't want to stand here with only one ability point left, so we're flying and just getting the hell out of there. On a different turn, we can, get him back into combat. Syken can also make sure that he's fortified. And clear-minded. All of this is very much possible. Let's give him some more magical armor. There we go. Alright, this here is Trumpdor. I want to make sure that Lowe's is reasonably far away so that she does not take too much of their burst damage. Let's move her over here. Got a nice little summoning. Trumpdor makes himself invisible. That's fine. Let's buff our blows. Very nice. And we can do the same with the Incarnate. And then Syken can slowly get into combat. I know how we can get Tromtor out of his stealth. Normally, if you are taking damage and you are invisible, you should reveal. You should be revealed. So what we could do. Is hasting ourselves, by the way. Okay, Lose's companion never entered combat, apparently. Which means this here is a combat-free zone. Yep. Interesting. So we... Let me try something. We can't teleport her away. I wanted to teleport her out to see if she could leave combat, but... That might not be possible. Anyway, standing here. Yep, the Bone Witch is in combat and that's fine. Good. So, Lose just lost her incarnate. Cooldown. Getting some totems. By the way, everyone's in combat now. And that is pretty much it. I think she has a good position there. As long as these guys are just waiting here and we only focus on one Tromtor at a time for now, it's actually going to be a good setup. I would keep him, simply keep him there. Don't even need to shield up. I would rather take 6 ability points next turn. We need to make the Tromtoy, the real Tromtoy, show. These guys here are all fake images. This guy is going to be a problem. Hope he just stays with the spider for now. Good, the spider deals some damage, and elsewise I would just let it bury down here so that it takes him further away. We have no idea what... Oh, wait, we do have an idea. No, we don't. This is not the real Tromtoy. This is just a guy who simply moved there. We have no real idea where Tromtoy is. So he may or may not be there. I am going to prepare though, since Sybil has problems when she's being targeted. We're just going to make her invisible. I'm pretty sure the real Tromtoy is going to come in. And this should be it. So one way of revealing the real Tromtoy is, as you can see, I prepared the entire floor. Okay, so that did not work out. He might not be there yet. Let's haste ourselves and wait for next turn. There's the real Tromtoy. His global cooling failed. Mainly because he's no longer on ice or in water. He's on poison, which cannot be frozen. So he's still fortified. We can't just teleport him out, and it would be suicidal to try that. Instead, at the very edges of this here, I want to put totems. Reason why I want to do that and not inside here is we're soon going to change to fire. And by changing to fire, everything will explode. Hence, those totems here will go away. I really want to play more aggressive, but unfortunately the game on this specific setting with this specific difficulty completely prevents me from doing that. We need to basically single-handedly pick out this Tromtoy here and then immediately burst him down. That's our chance to win. We're going to shield up, mainly to get some more armor. Rebuffing, getting all of the totems and everyone else buffed up. And we're saving our ability points. Can the real Tromtoy please stand up? Feels like an Eminem song. Yeah, I don't want to lose our good position here. We're absolutely maximum buffed up. As soon as someone comes in, I'll be able to deal with that guy. Yeah, got good shooting angles here. That's fine. We got a reposition with tactical retreat. That's also fine. Feels like such a waste to end the turn. So this is at least hitting home. Let's summon a blocker. And let's prepare wings just in case we need to reposition. This here is the real Tromtoy, which means prior to him, we're going to see two other Tromtoys going. So spider buries in. No, that's the real Tromtoy. My bad. Ah, that is the real Tromtoy. Now we're wasting his time to move here, okay? Well,
glory is mine.
I misjudged. This here is a fake trumpdoor. The real one has a staff, so should have seen that coming. At least this will set him back, which is good, because the archer is dealing a lot of damage. Essentially having him back there is helpful. So if we were, if we were to move to here, just one AP. Okay. Can we? No, can't yet. Another AP in. Take Tromdoy. Move him here. And essentially, charge back here. Okay, full focus on getting Tromdoy down. He has both physical and magical armor. I think we want to go with physical armor here. That was unfortunate. Good. If we were to get rid of this guy here, even for a few moments, let's put him here, for instance. They have moderate magical resistance, so we could actually work with that. How much magical resistance does Ifan have? Looking at 160. This here should hit both, but not Ifan. Yep, there we go. Okay. Alright, this guy could be taken over. The real Tromdoy can act next. Of course, he's stealing damage to our main DPS. Okay, Lose takes over this guy here, Charmed. Make sure that Tromto is right where he's supposed to. And for Sibyl, just want to make sure that with evasion, she has the maximum chance of not being one shot. He just blind everyone. What a prick. Good, some solid damage. This Tromtoy unfortunately hasn't lost all of his armor yet. Difficult. What can we do? Continue dealing damage to this guy here. Let's use physical damage. Sibyl heals herself and luckily first aid also removes blindness. So we're jumping over here. Continuing to focus on Tromtoy. Nice. And his physical damage is, or his physical armor is almost down. So, moving over here. Got him now fully stripped of physical armor, and Syken is healing, is hasting himself. I'm ready. Lose continues to help Sibyl. Damn, this guy ended up right next to Sibyl. Alright, so moving over here. This here can take him out for one round. He's sleeping. In the meantime, we're focusing on Tromtoy. Nice little adrenaline buff. And let's knock him down. Also, let's heal Sibyl. He's charmed and he's luckily moving into the right direction. Let's fully focus on killing this guy. Feels without high ground that we're dealing almost zero damage to him. Okay, he's sleeping. Next turn we can deal with him. Let me think. Summoning wouldn't be bad, but we can't do that. We're currently on blood. So we could buff living living it on the edge. We could also make sure that this guy here simply entangled going forward. That we fly into the corner. Plus buff ourselves to survive. Okay, making sure that we deal the maximum amount of damage. So fully buffed up in Incarnate, which by the way can also crowd control next turn. Luckily, Lowe's is pretty tanky. Gotta deal with this guy here. Let's chicken Tromtoy simply because it's a very strong crowd control. Okay, Let's continue to focus on him. He's at least slowed. I was hoping that I could cripple him, but unfortunately physical armor prevents that, of course. What are we going to do? Let me think. Also needs some armor. So we need to buff her. He needed some armor. Need to buff him. Chicken is almost down. Lowe's buffs everyone. And since we don't have an armor buff anymore, let's drink a medium armor potion. That was definitely the wrong target. Sibyl moves up. One hit. Two hits down. Ooh. Close fight. And we got a lot of XP out of it. Damn it. That indeed was close. So, Tromdai got us an intelligence constitution and curse drink, which we don't need. The good old band of backers. There is a set of armor, called the armor of backers, which indeed is pretty good once you have all of them, because then you can, only if you equip all of them, you will have a non-cursed version. As long as you keep either of them in a non-complete set, you will get stacking debuffs. The Tromdai's hatchet is just incredibly good. Unfortunately, we're not using axes, which makes it less appealing. And we got a lot of really solid loot out of it. Oh, and of course, we can level up. So, I think Iban in this fight did really, really well. Got a nice little showcase out of it, why that build works out so well. We are continuing to go with Warfare. Normally, I would upgrade the other skills simply because we will and go into Necromancy with him. We could even do that, because that will make him more tanky. Living on the edge, for instance, is super helpful. And having more wits allows him to even have a wider repertoire. Plus, Necromancy has a couple of skills, such as Mosquito Swarm, healing him. and at the same time dealing damage at range, which clearly this build does not necessarily excel at. With Lowe's, we are continuing to go into summoning. We're almost at the point, just due to how crazy the leveling here is, that we will get bigger incarnates. Yeah, we can go all the way into intelligence. For Sibyl, we're continuing finesse. It's a relatively straightforward build, and as you can see, we have almost reached maximum warfare. And we have a massive amount of damage. Alone from warfare, we're having an increase of 55%, plus 90% from finesse. So her basic attack is probably at the moment our most damage. Just for now, I will skill the lore masterpiece so that we can identify all of the items. Clearly you can reskill it as needed, but let's take a look at the items. We do that in a second. Let's very quickly or very briefly skill the rest of it. Syken could use another slot here, just because he has so many really decent abilities, and I feel we can't use the full potential that he has available. So I'm going to go one in memory and one in intelligence. As for his normal abilities, he has pretty much all we need for now. So we're continuing polymorph to get to a higher intelligence faster. And for additional skills, I'd like to go with Cloak and Dagger, probably, just to have another movement ability for him. Chameleon Cloak is also an option, specifically after he has used Adrenaline and when he needs to get out of trouble. Of course, Heart of Steel is also a great ability. You know what? He's so much in trouble. I'm just going with Heart of Steel for now. Lose has a lot of really helpful skills. Soulmate could be something that I could see, but at the same time, giving her at least one offensive ability isn't the worst decision either. Specifically when we start out with water. Could even go for Fossil Strike. You know what? Yeah, let's do that. She can support with a bit of Earth Magic just to slow the enemy down. Sibyl here. Pretty clearly haste. Maybe chloroform isn't bad for crowd control, but she should spend her skill points predominantly on getting faster and dealing more damage. Good. Syken. By the way, this here is the summoned cat ability that I spoke about. So the cat survived all the way through the castle, which gave us this ability. I can already summon it, but we do have not enough memory slots. It's a good ability, but not kind of the prime ability. So what could Syken use? Certainly a restoration. I mean, that's just an overall very strong skill. And I'd like to continue with Corpse Explosion, probably. should have given him one more constitution, because whenever we flesh sacrifice, it also... Oh, it reduces the constitution by minus 3. Never mind. So probably shields are not the right thing for him then, or we need to substantially upgrade his constitution. Good. Corpse explosion could have been helpful. I'm also contemplating to go deeper into air magic, because a lot of it will stun the enemy, specifically if you can use it together with water. But I'm fine for now. The playstyle works. We could definitely, or you could definitely go and take two different schools of magic as well. In terms of items, these here are pretty good. Thievery gloves, like it. But it also increases critical strike chance. And despite the fact that teleportation magic is really good, probably better off with those gloves, specifically on a tank. Scoundrel and Retribution is helpful. We got 60 hit points on the staff. Unfortunately, not enough intelligence on it. Yeah, Ifan is getting a decent amount of armor. So I think he's doing well. The Amulet of the Dead looks nicely. We need to get rid of our source colors, collars as soon as possible. Anyways, to end this episode, let's take a look at the treasure chamber of Bacchus Rex. A few lucky find. Soul jars. There's the Heart of the Tyran. Level 6 armor. Normally a really good armor. Once you're if you're here with a lower level. There's the Purging Wand, which is a helpful one that we would need. Probably something for Syken. That way he can also use his blood sacrifice. Got another ring. Necromancer and summoning. I think that is a perfect option for us. So we're officially now at summoning 9. Which, if I can find another item, we will get better incarnates. Really nice helmet. And at the same time, we're trying to increase the defense of Sibyl just a tiny bit. So I gave her a ring with the skill.
As long as the jar stays unbroken. Really? You. He drops to his. Thank you.
Good. We just defeated Tromdoy and dealt with him. I like the intelligence plus pyro helmet. That looks helpful. Let's see, Syken has a Scoundrel Geomancer helmet. Arguably better than ours.
The jar before you, the sword, as soon as the vision, a shadow, as you pull your hand away, you can feel. Lucky find.
Good. Once you're done here, there's a very brief interlude. And then we are going to end the video. Fun fact, did you know that this here originally in Divinity Original Sins 2 was planned to be the hideout? So players were supposed to be able to build their home there. They ended up deciding against it, and so they came up with that whole different dimension of the gods thing. So for those of you who have never played it, that was the dimension of gods. We're ending with a little bit of crafting. Whenever you find, for instance, mushrooms or alike, make sure that you try using them with empty potion bottles, which you should have plenty. Because almost every single herb will grant a nice combination, fire resistance elixirs, and so on and so forth. And if for nothing else, you can usually sell them for pretty decent face value. Intestines plus, I got myself a water barrel finally. Like right there. Good. And in terms of arrows, I think we can produce a few of them. Get a few poison arrows and a few shocking arrows. By the way, the wrong person. You should always select the right person to create these things. In this case, it was in Syken's inventory. Okay, there we go. Good. Which brings us to the end of this episode. What are we going to see in the next episode? Now that we've cleared out the hideout here, the Vault of Bacchus Rex, I think we need to go and do his tower, which you're going to see right here. So we're going to do all of the fights in there. If I remember correctly, there should be two really good fights. Starting area here in his courtyard, and one inside. Thank you so much for watching. We are on our way to crush it and to defeat act number one. If you enjoyed what you've seen, hit the like button and leave a comment down below. Thank you, and see you soon. Bye bye.